class 4th English reader. Let's continue the our story of Ming, the dragon who grew. In this story, we already learned about the dragon, who is very small and very cute. He didn't impress and process to anyone. That's why he left his home. So from that place, I will continue here. So, when the sun was high in the sky and street was full of noisy activities, Ah Ming suddenly appeared. He expected everyone to come running to meet him, to stroke his hat, to admire his colors, and to ask his name. Instead, there was the most terrible confusion. People dropped everything and ran. Doors were slammed and bolted, windows closed, and mothers had their children. In a moment, the street was empty. Oh dear, whatever is that? Is the matter? Oh, said Ah Ming. Surely they can't be frightened of me. He walked very slowly and carefully down the village street until he came to the village fountain, with its lovely clear pool of water. Sitting on the low wall around the pool was a small boy. Ah Ming stopped at once, and he and the boy looked at each other. Why has everybody run away? Asked Ah Ming. I am not going to hurt anyone after all. I am just a very tiny dragon. Really? Said the little boy in surprise. I am afraid everyone was very, very frightened of you. They thought you were going to eat them up. I nearly ran away myself, but my grandfather had been telling me such wonderful old stories about dragons. I thought I would stay and see what you really looked like, how very, very large you are. Large? Said Ah Ming in astonishment. Me? Because we already know about that, the Ah Ming was very small. And due to that, he had to left his house. But now the boy telling him about that Ah Ming is now very large. He shook his head. Why, I am perhaps the smallest dragon in the world. That's why I had to leave home. You have made a big mistake, said the small boy. Just took a look at yourself, Ah Ming. Turned and looked down into the bright clear water of the pool and suddenly saw that he was simply enormous. He was puffing out clouds of smoke into the still air, his tail stretched out behind him, his neck curved high, his eyes glittered like jewels. Oh dear, said Ah Ming, what has happened to me? You look simply beautiful, a real dragon, said the small boy. If you honestly don't eat up people, I will hurry off and tell them all that you are quite harmless. They will come out of their houses and look at you, he added. In a short time, Ah Ming was surrounded by an admiring crowd. The children climbed on his back, little boy sat on his tail, babies were held up to stroke his cheeks. He felt very happy, everybody really liked him. Now, he made friends as he said before. After a lot of talk and discussion, the village council decided to adopt Ah Ming as their special dragon. So nearly every day he came down from his cave and stretched out on the village street. He took up a great deal of room, but he was very careful not to knock down any of the stalls, and the children were able to play the most exciting games. Jumping over his back and sliding down his tail, his fame soon spread abroad and people came from far and wide to see him. Now he is an entertaining piece for the people, and many people came to see him in very, very far places. Ah Ming was very happy at festivals and holidays. He always led the processions. He was gentle and good-tempered with the children and polite to everyone. Luckily, he stopped growing through the godfather fat. He is living there to this day, a contented and satisfied dragon. So this is the story about the Ah Ming who make friends after becoming a very large enormous very enormous dragon. So this is the story, and here is the word meanings. We have to learn it. Thank you.